You're now listening to Hype South Child Time with Dio Gervais, Boss Lady J, only on GMT Radio, every Monday from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m.
It got started in my house, man, out there. I used to live in Rosewood. And when I started doing slowed down mixes, I didn't want to call them screw mixes. You know what I mean? I call my mixes Swisher mixes, and I call my studio the Swisher House.
Where the Swisher House name come from?
I used to call my mixes Swisher mixes. And, you know, just because they were slowed down because I didn't want to call them screw mixes.
And right. In my head, it's like a studio full of empty sweet guts everywhere and empty switch boxes and stuff like that.
I ain't gonna lie to you, back then that was basically how it was.
A bunch of roaches everywhere.
No, it wasn't roaches there.
Roaches.
Hey, you know what, I'm gonna tell you something, man.
So the name came honestly.
I had the Acres Home Crew over there with Mario and them around there. Hey, there wasn't nothing left around there. They was some real smokers around there.
They'll
take them and roll them up into a full blunt. And before you know it, that's getting smoked out there too.
How did you get all of the Powwows, the Slim Thugs, the Lil Marios, everybody, how did you get everybody down with Swisher House?
Man, I'm not gonna lie to you, man. I gotta give a shout out to Lil Mario, cause I ain't gonna lie. If I didn't meet Lil Mario, I don't think that whole Acres Home crew would even made it over there, man. Lil Mario was the first person from Acres Home at my studio, you know what I mean? Mario is the one that introduced me to Slim Thug, 50/50 Twin, J-Dawg, and everybody just kind of just a friend brought a friend in, you know? Yeah. And that's how it just grew, man. You know, Slim Thug probably come in and say, man, this is my homeboy such and such right here, man. Yeah. He'll come through there, you know what I mean? Like Ron will say, man, this is my boy Sab Waffle. He came and I did Sab Waffle, bring somebody else to that, you know? Yeah, and it just kind of just grew into this big, huge family, you know? I'm gonna tell you, Rhett, I can only speak for my end. I can't speak for anybody else, right? But I'm an admirer of DJ Screw, right? Yeah. And I always have been, and I am still to this day, right? You know, but it was a division between the city way before
the music.
The north side and south side were like Bloods and Crips. Exactly. That's how it was at that point. You know what I mean? I met Screw three times, right? And out of the three times that I met him, it has never been no hostility or no negativity between us. You know, I ain't gonna lie, it's never been that. But I heard him talk some shit about me on some of his mixtapes. Screw has. It's amazing from where he stopped at and what his legacy has impacted on the industry right now, right?
Yeah.
I could imagine how much stronger it would be if he was still here today. You know what I mean? I mean, they'll probably have a freaking statue of this man downtown. They should have one right now, honestly. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you something. While we're talking about Screw, right? And, you know, and everybody got these days out here, man. I don't understand why DJ Screw does not have an official day.
No one has went for it yet.
When it come down to this, when it come down to the Houston culture, right, it's Screw. You know what I mean?
Right, yeah.
I'm gonna tell you something, man. I feel like if it wasn't for Screw starting to slow down music, you know, John around here, right? I don't even think that trap music would even exist right now, because all the music right now,
the whole world.
All the music is produced right now at 60 to 70 BPM, majority of the hits right now, right?
Talk to him, why?
And before, while Screw's live, right? Man, we didn't have music that slow. Honestly, everything before Screw started slowing down stuff, right? All our hip hop was 80 beats per minute to 100.
Right.
Everything was 80 to 100.
Everyone is
and at that point, if your song was 80 beats per minute, it was considered being slow. At that point, it was too slow to dance off of in the club.
You know, for a long time, Houston rappers and Houston artists for a long time had been like, half a major deal.
Yeah.
What happened to make y'all just go ahead and, you know what I'm saying?
They cut the check.
Hey, that money changed.
You know, it's like, man, you can say fuck it till all you want to, but at that point right there, man, you realize
been
that
trying
you
to could, get at y'all?
You could grow, you could, when you realize, as far as artists are concerned, right, you think about, number one, you think about that check at that point, and then you think about how much more you could do with that, because at the end of the day, our whole squad was hustlers, right?
Right, yeah.
So we knew with that extra exposure that they got, we got, man, regardless if they didn't cut us a check with the extra exposure, we knew we was going to eat anyway.
Right. Yeah. That was the whole play for
them. I mean, you got to realize that these guys here with the Swiss House, right, even before they even had an album, all these dudes had cribs, cars, everything.
Numbers.
Right.
I mean, nobody had no commercial shit out at all, period. And they were eating already, so you can imagine what was going to happen with real exposure. You know what I mean?
How long were they just tugging at y'all, like, getting y'all off?
I ain't gonna lie, I think they've been tugging at us by like 5 years before we just broke down and really went with it, you know what I mean?
That's dope.
That number got high.
That number got high. They hit the sweet spot.
I mean, because at that point
right there, man, really on the cool, we was moving so much product, man, we was actually killing retail. You know what I mean? Our stuff was moving. A lot of the independent stores, man, they was totally surviving off of us at that point right there. You know what they gonna happen about with all the guys that was involved with the Swiss House, man? All those guys turned out to be successful businessmen. You know what I mean?
Right. Like, seriously.
And I'm really happy for that, man. You know, it's just like, man, like, I always wanted a son, and I never had one, so I'm like, these kids, these dudes here, I watch these dudes grow from kids to men and be successful with what they have to do. You know what I mean? And you know one thing about it, man, just like, man, in my mind, it's like, I know how people feel about the Screwed Up Click and Swiss House, man, and knowing that Kiki is the ambassador of the Screwed Up Click captain, man. I know that he caught a lot of flack behind that. And I really didn't, in my mind, I knew what kind of flack he was going to get because how people think about that, but it wasn't about that with me, man. You know, it's just like, we want to give this man an opportunity to be on the level that he's supposed to be on. Right. You know what I mean?
Right.
You know, my thing is not to take him away from the Screwed Up Click or take him away from the South Side or nothing that he represents. You know what I mean? I want him to expand himself. You know what I mean?
And there was no other way he was going to do that at that time other than, you know,
Because my thing is, man, this man deserves it, man.
Absolutely.
At that point, man, when you think about Houston, Kiki is Houston, man. When you think about that legend that you look up to, like 2 Chainz or something like that, man, they looked up to UGK and Kiki. Right. You know what I mean?
Right. Man,
this man was inspiration for our inspiration. You know what I mean?
Yeah, man.
Right. I have never took the time out to really even count it. But I can tell you one thing. I got like 200 mixes I never even released.
Wow.
Dope. Yeah, I got 200 mixes I never released, man. It's crazy, man. I did stuff like T.I. and all kind of crazy stuff, man. I did Young Buck's first album. I never released that. It's crazy, man. I did Master P's Ghetto Dope. I never released that. You know what I mean? I did R. Kelly's The R album. I never released that. You know what I mean?
Let me give you our email address right quick, man.
Drop an
exclusive right quick.
Man, I'm telling you the new thing I did David Banner's God Box.
And I did
like 4 albums for David Banner and used them when David Banner does a commercial record. I think I only missed one of them. I think I missed one of them, but I did God Box. That's the new one I did. You know what I mean?
So being out there talking to the people. I learned that from selling my record in the street for a very long time. You see what I'm saying? For a very long time. My family like that for a long time. This music was never a game to me. You see what I'm saying? This is life.
And you got a new mixtape coming up?
I got a new dropping coming, man. I'm talking about some nice. I've been waiting on the time. You know what I'm saying? To drop it right. Summertime is here.
Hot summer.
And I'm telling you, it's going to be a real hot one,
going
baby.
Going to be a hot summer.
And Best of Texas dropping. You see what I'm saying? Best of Texas dropping.
And where number 7 is what brewing, right?
Come on, man. And you know what? From since it's been dropping, man, come on, man. We got over 1-2 million views, bro. People is listening, man. All over Texas, people is listening, man. And they love the Best of Texas. I've been getting calls from everywhere.
Yeah.
So it's just like, and I've been having people hitting my pages from everywhere. That's how I know it's working. And that Best of Texas jamming, I be jamming it. You see what I'm saying? So shout out to everybody that's been on the Best of Texas.
Me and Rip hooked up from a mutual friend named 50 Pack, right? Rest in peace to 50 Pack, right? 50
Pack.
So 50 Pack said, man, look, man, I got a homie over here named Rip, man. He got some fire over here, right? So that night, they were at the studio, and I happened to be free. I said, well, you know what? I'm going to come over there and roll up on you, right? And, man, he played like 3 tracks for me, man. And you know what? To be honest with you, I have never heard anybody play me 3 tracks that was new, right? I have never heard of Rip at this point, never seen him or nothing.
All on the
right?
same mixtape.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think the mixtape was done yet, but he let me hear 3 tracks, right, that he had, right? And I ain't gonna lie, I liked all 3 of them. I was just totally impressed by that because it's very rare nowadays when you got somebody that can even give you 1 song. But if somebody could let me hear 3 songs and I like all 3 of them, and I'm a really harsh critic, you know what I mean? One thing about me, I'm gonna tell you right in your face, if I don't like it, I'm gonna tell you I don't like it. Yeah. You know?
And so what? How does that feel hearing that riff?
That's actually it hearing amazing, it? Amazing, man. Word. Come on, man. I've been wanting to know Five since I was a kid.
Yeah.
Come on, man. I was raised up out there in Houston,
right.
You know?
Absolutely.
So I'm telling you, I ran up on Mr. 5000 before he even knew me. He was at the Warehouse Live outside about to get something to eat. I ran up on him. And I was so nervous. I ain't even shaking.
You his head. Nervous?
I was nervous. I was younger, yeah. But I mean, you know, I was scared because he's like, man, he's a legend, man.
Yeah.
But I ain't want to approach him the wrong way. I just said, hey, man, you know, I'm such and such, and you know, I do music. One day you're going to hear about me.
That's the best intro.
Yeah, hey, that was corny.
Hey,
that was corny. But it was like, and you know what he told me? He said, okay, cool, that's what's up. And he went back. and he went back, hey, man, let me get my food, man. Let me get my food.
And look at y'all now.
You're look at y'all now. Listening to Hype Southside Time with Steel Gervais, Boss Lady J, only on GMT Radio, every Monday from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m.